Hey everybody, this is Lad Mandiola here with Renew Tech Solutions, and we represent the Ultimate Knife. And the main reason why we're here representing the Ultimate Knife is because of the amazing wave catch feature from Ernie Amberson himself, and I got him standing right here, so without looking at me too much further, I'd rather go here. So hi Ernie, how you doing?
Very good.
One of the things I wanted to ask you, one of the main things, is what was it that got you started in just knives in general? What was it to begin with?
The reason that I got into knives, because I was a starving student. I had moved all the way from Wisconsin out to California, and I was at a training school that at that time was the only full contact fighting school in the world, with some gentlemen named Dan Insano and Richard Stillo. At that time, there was a lot of work that they did with the Valley Songs and all that, and I was at a point where I really couldn't even pay for the dues from the school. I'd end up cleaning up the bathrooms and stuff like that to pay for my dues, and the dues were only $12.50 a month, so I was real, real poor. And the point is that I couldn't even afford to buy a Valley Song knife, so I said, you know what, I think I can make one of these. I had a drill, and I had some files and vice and all that, so I made one of those Valley Songs, and just for me, and then I found out that some of the other guys at the school were also poor, and they said, hey, if you make one of those for us, we'll pay for all the materials. And so that actually started me in making knives, and it just took off from there. So I really kind of owe everything back, again, back to the fighting parts that was involved.
Well, great. What got you with the wave catch feature? What is that feature? I mean, what made you think about that?
Well, you know, it's funny, because what happened was I was working in, this was later, in about 20 years past that, when I made the first Valley Song. I was working with the United States Navy SEAL teams and made a bunch of knives for them and was doing some stuff like that. And they said, look, we want to do a knife that has a quote-unquote blade-catching feature on the top of the back of the blade. And I said, well, you know, why is that? They said, well, in case we're ever in a confrontation with a knife, there'd be something to basically catch a blade if it slipped up the back of the knife. And I said, well, that's probably easy enough to accomplish. So I said, let me work on it. So we went ahead and I designed a knife, it's called the Commander knife, and put that little hook on top, which at that time, that's all it was a little hook on the top. And they came up to my house. I'm 90 miles away from Coronado, Naval Special Warfare Base. So they came up and they said, holy smokes, this is exactly what we want. And here's the funny part of the story. I had no idea what the wave actually could do or would do. And I kept a prototype for myself. They took the prototype and jetted back down to Coronado. About an hour and a half later, I've got the knife in my pocket, and I'm pulling it out of my pocket, and the blade partially opens when I pull it out, and I go, wow, that's kind of cool. Right when I was doing that, the phone rings. It's the Navy SEAL team guys, a guy named Mike Ferguson, and he goes, Ernie, you know what this knife does? And I go, yeah, I just figured it out. He goes, hell, it opens up when you pull it out of your pocket. And I go, yeah, I said, it sure does. And he says, you know what else it does? You can open a beer bottle with it. And I go, okay, now we got all the important parts covered. So that's really kind of how that came about. And the name, the wave, if you will, the wave-shaped feature, really just refers to the fact that it's got a wave shape to it. Because we live in California, land of the surfers and all that.
Yeah.
So that was kind of appropriate.
That's cool.
But that's really how that came about. It was one of those, I'd like to say I was a genius and I really figured this all out. It was really almost an accidental discovery, and I guess that's the way a lot of things come about.
Cool. One of the last things I wanted to find out, though, is out of all the knives, what is it about the Karambit knife that makes it one of your favorite knives?
Well, you know, that's an easy answer to that question, because if we go back to those Valley Songs, you know, a knife is a knife. What it is it has an edge on it, has a handle on it. But if you can do something with a knife, that just makes it all that more fun to have. And I'll tell you, that was one of the reasons that I was so intrigued by the Valley Song knife, is because, as everyone knows, you can flip it around and you can do all kinds of neat stuff with it, which really has nothing to do with the knife and the way that it performs, or if you were ever to have to use it in a self-defense situation. But it makes the knife interesting. but it is also functional. Well, here we go with the Kravitz, the same thing. And it has the finger hole on the end, so you can flip the knife all over, which, again, is the fun part of the knife. But at the same time, it's a very, very functional feature, because if your fingers are through that handle, you can drop that knife, you can pick up a gun and shoot with that knife, I can hit the deck with my hands down, and I would still have retention of that knife in my hand. And that really is what I believe to be one of the key features of the Kravitz knife, is the retention, the weapon retention feature, by having that hole in there. The other good thing is, if you think about the shape of a Kravitz blade, which I believe, if I'm correct, mimics the claw of a tiger. Now, if you think about what a tiger can do, an animal, think about what this blade can do. And again, I'm a big thing on evolution, as far as, you know, if a tiger's claws didn't work well, we wouldn't have tigers. So those claws are very, very efficient. They do the job well. So the same thing happens with the blade. That little curved blade, in fact, if you were to just do this with the knife as someone was trying to grab you, it would do terrible damage to them, you know, in a self-defense situation.
Yeah.
So it's an easy knife to learn how to use. It's very compact, and it's got that wave feature, so it's instantly deployed from what comes out of your pocket.
Okay.
So overall, it's probably one of the better self-defense knives that exists in the world, and I'm not talking about my knife, but the Kravitz knife in general is one of the best self-defense knives that exists.
That's great.
I know you guys are making some versions of it.
Yeah.
Again, they are absolutely stunning little knives. They're perfect. They're good for a girl. They're good for your wife. They're good for a guy. You don't have to be a complete martial arts guy to be able to use it. You can figure it out. There's good stuff out there. Videos and DVDs and things on the web that show you how to use one of these knives. And so overall, if you were going to pick a knife just to have in your pocket, if you're going into harm's way, this is a pretty damn nice knife to have. Again, I don't mean just our knife. Let me see that one you've got right there. Let's take a look at that.
There we go.
Same thing.
Yep.
You can see it has all those features that I'm talking about. The curve of the blade, the finger retention, the wave feature, and the hole opening feature. It's a nice, slim little devil, if you will.
Yeah.
And so these knives were perfect for self-defense, and they're actually a lot of fun. I will caution you, though, if you're going to be playing with this while you're sitting on your couch,
yeah.
You better put some tape on this, because
yeah.
You can poke yourself in the arm, or
you're better off getting this if you're wanting to train.
Yeah.
What, hence the reason why they call it the trainer.
That's right.
So,
but anyway, here we go. These are Kravitz. They're great knives. You'll have a lot of fun with them. But there's serious also. It's a fun toy, but it's a serious fun toy. And I just didn't have it kind of ingest, but nice set of knives.
One last thing I wanted to ask you is the relationship you have with the Frati family. How did they come to you about all of this with the wave catch feature, asking for the permission and all that? And how did that all work out?
That's a real interesting story in itself, because what happened was, and this goes back a little ways, I was teaching a class in California at Richard Vasilo's school, because we're still friends and we still interface with a lot of stuff. And it was an international instructors conference, and they brought me in to do some teaching module at the class. And there was a whole bunch of Italian special forces that happened to be at that school at that time. And so we did a lot of hands-on stuff with them. I guess they were a little bit impressed by what I did. And they also saw some of the knives, because I had the training knives there with the wave catch feature on them. And they were looking at that, and they were going, wow, this is very interesting. We'll be in touch. So a little time goes by. And sure enough, the family from Fox Knives shows up, and they said, we're developing a knife for the Italian Special Forces, and one of the things that they asked for specifically was, can we use that wave shape feature on these knives? So this is one of those long, winding road stories. I said, absolutely. Are you kidding? We support all the military units all over the world. We're fighting the good fight. I said, yes, let's make this happen. They signed an agreement with me. The wave feature went on that knife, and they turned out a real nice knife. It actually is one of used by the Italian Special Forces, wherever they may have ended up. And so we're real happy with that, too. So that's really, that to me is one of those kind of really cool stories.
Wow. Well, Ernie, thank you so much for your time. And this is just a pleasure to hear what you're
really
sharing. So thank you again.
I wish you guys all the luck with your product. You make real fine knives.
Thank you. Thank you.